In this empty drawing, we draw an arc in the default freehand way. Then we copy it multiple times. In the property palette, we see the arc has a radius of 563.9081. Drawing arcs with a freehand is useful, but we want to avoid such fractional radii. That's why we type R, O, A to start the round off arc radius command. In the main menu, we see the default settings. We type a D for delete to toggle it to no, so we see the effect the command has. Then we type a P for precision, the most important setting. There are three options. We type an M for midpoint, the first option. After we confirm the other settings, the command asks us to select an arc. We select the first arc, after which the command asks us to enter a radius. The command already makes a suggestion that is rounded off, but we enter 500 so we can see the effect. The command drew a new arc that has its midpoint on the same position as the selected arc. The start and end angle also match the selected arc. We type R, O, A again. We set the position to endpoints this time. After confirming the settings, we select the second arc and enter 500 again. This time, the new arcs start and end match the selected arc. We run the command again and set the position to center this time. We select the last arc and enter 500 again. This time, the center points match. We clear the drawing and draw new arcs. We run the command and see it is in its default settings. We enter a C for continuous to toggle it to yes. We confirm the settings and select the first arc. After we entered a radius, the command asks for the next arc now. We continue to select the other arcs to round off the radius. Running off the radius of arcs of this size means the changes are hardly visible. The radius, however, has a round value now, which is what we want. Thanks for watching this tutorial. For more information and more commands, check urbanlisp.com.